Because there is no way a person who have kids, who have children, a person who started, a person who's a doctor, can go and sign those oppressive kind of laws and put them into effect. It can never. Because we need to have experience. We need to feel like others. You need to say, if this is happening to me, how will I feel? Do you understand what I'm saying? So, there is nothing to worry, because remember, in the papers that they give to us, they always write, start work and do and do it and study. Was that true? Was that happening? So, it is better now it comes to light, and everyone now around the world that knows that a refugee is no longer going to be allowed to wait. Instead of people saying that in your paper is written this and that, but it's already very clear that a refugee can no longer wait. But where is the help? If you don't wait, what are you going to do? You understand what I'm saying? Who's there to help you? So, it only takes the one who's suffering to understand the kind of pain that you are in. If you are waiting for someone else to stand for your problem, you will always be the victim. Understand what I'm saying? And remember, every time when xenophobic attacks, they want to start killing and looting people, they always bring kind of excuses and say, foreign nationals shot one of a South African child, shot one of the South. In Upington, they said foreign nationals first at the beginning. He killed a police officer. That was the first motive that they started the xenophobic attacks. But now, that kind of accusation is no longer there. Now they are saying Nigerians are selling what? Drugs. But when they're chasing everyone, they're not choosing Nigerians. They're following you, whether you are a Nigerian, whether you are whatever. They